So this time I have taken a problem from Erodo, and your problem is like this. What amount of heat will be generated in the circuit shown in figure 3.31? This is your figure. This is your figure. After the switch est blue is shifted from position 1 to position 2. Okay. So initially the position was 1. When switch 1 is on, switch 2 is out of the game, and when switch 2 is on, switch 1 is out of the game. And I will draw this figure one after another and we'll calculate. Let's see. Now when switch 1 is on, this is your capacitor, and here is your switch 1, and your batteries are connected like this. This is your E1 and this is your E2. Now suppose Q amount of charge is Q1, and I am applying Kirchhoff's loop here. So minus E2 plus E1 plus Q1, and C is the capacity. Q1 by C is equal to 0. And what I get solving this, I get Q1 is equal to C into E2 minus E1. Now switch 1 is taken away to position 2, and when switch 1 is taken to position 2, your figure is corresponding figure is going to be like this. So here is your switch 2, okay, and your cell is E1 here, and Q2 amount of charge is passing through it, and C is the capacity. So using again Kirchhoff's loop rule, what I get, Q2 by C, E1 plus Q2 by C is equal to 0. So I get Q2 is equal to minus E1 into C. Okay. Now let me find del Q. What is going to be your del Q? So your del Q is going to be Q2 minus Q1, that is minus E1 C Q2 minus Q1 minus Q1. This is C E2 minus E1, and I get del Q is equal to minus C E1 minus C E1 minus C E2 plus C E1, and C E1 and C E1 cancels. So my del Q is equal to what I get, del Q is equal to minus C E2. So far so good. And your heat generation will be, generation of heat is going to be your work done by the battery, work by the battery and that means what additional charge flows after the changing of the arrangement. So after changing of the arrangement, only E1 is in the circuit. So when the additional charge or the rearrangement of charge during the process of changing the switch, the difference in charge that has only is scope to pass through E1. So E1 only come into play. So work done by the battery minus work done by the battery, this what an change in energy, potential energy of the cells, that is initial energy minus final energy. Oh, sorry, final energy minus initial energy. Okay, so here using conservation of energy, So heat produced is work done by the battery. Battery will do some work minus change in potential energy of the cell. So heat produced is equal to work done by the battery. I will take modulus CE2 into E1. Because whatever with the charge pass, the work done, the battery has to do this much work. And minus work done by the cells or change in energy of the cells during the arrangement. So it is going to be half C E1 square minus half C E1 minus E2 whole square. E1 minus E2 whole square. This is a change in potential of the cells. And this is the work done by the battery. And this difference in energy will result in heat. So some work will be done by the battery when charges passes through it. And these are the work done due to the rearrangement of the capacitors, because when capacitors are rearranged, their charges are different, and so the energy of the capacitors are also different in two different cases. So your del H is this is E1, so C E2 E1 C E2 E1 minus half C E1 square minus C will be there half C E1 square plus E2 square minus twice E1 E2, and everything you can take minus sign here, and everything will be inside the mod. So whatever with the value comes, I will take the modulus. It may come negative. I don't know whether it will come negative or positive. Whatever with the value comes after, I don't know. But I will take the modulus. E2 E1 minus. And we get half C E1 square minus half C E1 square minus half C E2 square. Half C E2 square plus C E1 E2. Okay. So C E1 E2, C E1 E2 cancels. And C E1 square and C E1 square also gets cancelled. And minus minus plus. So finally I am getting minus plus result, so no problem at all. It is going to be half C E2 square, half C minus of minus plus half C E2 square. So finally I am getting the heat produced is equal to half C E2 square. And you can see from the figure that it is independent of E1. It is independent of E1. And this is your result, half C E2 square. Okay.